The Army has gone out of their way to make the memorial as accessible as possible. They're a key partner here at Port Chicago, while simultaneously managed in a military operation here. They are a primary partner in providing access, and I'd like to invite Lieutenant Colonel Curtis Yankee, the commander of the 834th Battalion here at Military Ocean Terminal Concord, to say a few words.
Good morning. Ladies and gentlemen and honored guests, as the commander of Military Ocean Terminal Concord, better known as MODCO, which encompasses the former Port Chicago Naval Magazine, I would like to welcome everyone. As the only Department of Defense installation with an active National Park Service monument, we are honored to be able to provide access to this important national memorial and honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice. Here on display today and around the nation, our monuments pay tribute to veterans who gave their lives in service of our great nation. They stand as a beacon of light and an inspiration for a better tomorrow. The story of Port Chicago is one of courage, nobility, and service. These fallen heroes represent the character of our nation, one that has a long history of patriotism and honor. If our sense of security remains steadfast, it is because of brave men and women like those men that died on the evening of July 17, 1944. These fallen heroes are a reminder of the sacrifices made for the freedoms we enjoy today. And today is set aside to remember those who died and an opportunity to remember heroes lost. I appreciate and thank everyone for coming out on this beautiful Wednesday morning to honor our nation's fallen heroes. Thank you for coming out.